Hey, Chris Menard here. Let's take a look at the Formula Auditing group. I'm going to show you four different commands you have there, but I'm also going to show you one additional feature that I love that is on the Home tab. So let's dive in right now. So on the current file we have running, we've got two worksheets at the bottom. I'm on the worksheet called Write. I can click around and see my formulas. I'm in cell E2, and there's the formula up in the formula bar. If I move over to D2, that's just a constant. It's just a number. One more, if I click down in cell B10, there is a formula there again. I want to actually select all my formulas and maybe put them in a different fill color. I can do that on the Home tab, Find and Select, Formulas. They're all selected. Maybe I want to put them in a yellow color. Now they're all highlighted in yellow. I'm going to undo that one time, Control Z, just to show you that feature. I love that. Let's look at four more other items. They're all in the Formulas tab, and they can all be found in this Formula Auditing group. Another great feature. We're going to look at Trace Precedents, Trace Dependents. We'll remove some arrows, and I'll also use Show Formulas. So if I click, as an example, on this 146 down below, I want to know what numbers are going into that formula. What is it picking up? Well, I can see that it's B9 and B5, but I can click Trace Precedents, and notice there's a straight line, but it's got two dots in it showing me the two subtotals that I picked up. I can click it again, and now it's showing me where the number 60 picked up cell B2 to B4, and the number 86 picked up B6 to B8. If I want to remove these arrows, I can click Remove Arrows, but also have a trace dependence here. That 146 is being picked up in cell E10, the 480, that's trace dependence. I can click it again. The 480 is also being picked up in the total over in column R. And now we will actually click Remove Arrows. So in this file, act like someone emailed you this file and you've got to do a presentation on these numbers. You did not put the numbers together. You can't always do this, but this is a great example. I would come over to column R. I would select the largest number, which is 2,158. Trace precedence once. Notice it picked up the four circles. It picked up each quarter. Trace precedence the second time when you click it. Their numbers for the quarters are being picked up. I'm looking for consistency, and so far, so good. The third time, there we go. And finally, the fourth time, if you click it the fifth time, and nothing will happen because there's nowhere else to go. Remove arrows. I'm still in the 2,158. We're going to hit trace dependents. All those percentages are dependent on this number right here because I used absolute cell reference. In cell S2, S3, there's your absolute cell reference. Remove arrows. Now, if you want to actually print or just see your formulas and not the answers, that is Show Formulas. And there's the keyboard shortcut for it also displayed. And then click it again. You just toggle back and forth. Nothing to select. Try the keyboard. It's Control and the key to the left of number 1. Great keyboard shortcut for you there. Now, if you're wondering what would it look like if it was incorrect, let's go to the worksheet called Wrong. I'm in cell R10, trace precedence one time, looking correct. The second time, I'm getting worried. The third time, I'm really worried. And the fourth time, I would be coming back in here and just redoing all these formulas because it is incorrect. Remove arrows right there. Hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. This is part of my Excel online training class. Have a great day. Thank you.